what is the primary ideology or primary ideas that fuel Gorgoroth's music?
Satan.
What does Satan embody, or what does he represent?
Freedom.
Kristen Espedal, better known to the world as Ghaal, was born on August 7, 1975 in Sunfjord, Norway. While starting his musical career in the early 90s, he rose to fame in 1998 when he became the vocalist for the black metal band Gorgoroth.
It was the music. And I think most of the bands today are centered around the music. But of course you have bands like Gorgoroth who have the ideology still very much intact within the band, the satanic ideology.
Black metal entered the public eye between 1992 and 1996 when over 50 church burnings were connected to the black metal community. Because of this, many bands set to back down their satanic image and focus on the music. Gorgoroth did not ease up.
Church burnings and all these things are, of course, a thing that I support 100%, and it should have been done much more and will be done much more in the future. We have to remove every trace from what Christianity and the Semitic roots have to offer this world.
In a 2008 issue of Rock Hard, Ghaal finally confirmed to the metal community that he was gay. At the same time, he was financing a fashion line designed by his ex-boyfriend Dan DeVino.
For me, it's an issue, of course. It's and I've never seen it as a coming out, basically. It's,
okay, okay.
It's just that, just because the media makes a case out of it. It's not like I've gone to media and told them. It's just that one journalist dared to ask me, and I just answered him.
Funny, just as society is very interested in celebrities coming out of the closet, Ghaal's bravery in the ultra-masculine world of black metal went unnoticed by pop culture. It was not missed by the black metal community.
Because I also read that he received some threats from people from the black metal community. Was it true or is it not true?
I don't know how that is, how media makes things up. But I don't know that it's that might have been a comment on a forum or something. Yeah. That's,
it was much more than a comment on a forum. In a later interview, Dan DeVino stated that black metal fans had threatened him by letter, email, and even showing up to his front door. It was also alleged that at the Rockin' Open Air Festival, Ghaal lashed out at someone backstage who allegedly made a homophobic comment. According to reports, the assailant had to be hospitalized. Ghaal denies this ever happened.
Just by saying no to someone, punish them enough. And someone you probably need to cut to small pieces and sew back together.
Despite his support of church burnings and his violent tendencies, Ghaal was awarded the Gay Person of the Year Award at the 2010 Bergen Gay Gala. Although he accepted the award, Ghaal has gone on record saying that his sexual identity is not important to him.
Mankind is known to be narrow-minded, so so maybe some, but yeah, that's. But I guess it will even out the score in a way. So it's. I think it will be positive and for some, and negative for some.
Yeah.
It's always good to have some negative as well.
That's true.
It's, otherwise, you would end up with equality, and equality is the worst thing in the world.
And do you always strive then for inequality for yourself?
Yeah, of course. Equality is stagnation. It doesn't let anything grow. Yeah. It holds back.